Hey viewers, let's touch on a serious topic, one you've been hearing a lot about in the news. Coronavirus has become a worldwide epidemic. Over 2,000 people are confirmed to be infected, along with 81 deaths at the time of this recording. To make matters worse, experts have estimated that over 100,000 additional people have gone undiagnosed. Numerous cities have been locked down in China. So far, there are no vaccines or treatments to combat this. Today, we'll be talking about how exactly the coronavirus became a global epidemic. Where does its name come from? How was it first transmitted? Is there a way of preventing it? We're talking about all that and more. What is coronavirus? Before going into the origins, we first need to clear up exactly what coronavirus is. Coronavirus is a group of viruses with various effects. These viruses include Middle East Respiratory Syndrome, also known as MERS, and Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome, known famously as SARS. While it's displayed terrifying effects on animals such as pigs and chickens, its toll on humans has been nothing less than catastrophic. It's known to spread like any common sickness. This includes coughing and sneezing, physical contact, and sometimes fecal contamination. Coronavirus can also be contracted by touching a surface that's been infected. This is most likely to happen during the fall and winter months when the cold and flu season is at its highest. The disease has caused respiratory infections in humans. Some of the symptoms are said to include runny nose, headache, cough, sore throat, fever, and a general feeling of being unwell. What one might mistake as a common cold can gradually turn into a fatal illness. Minds from across the globe are coming together to figure out ways to fight against the virus. This is the perfect time to move on to our next big question. When did this outbreak begin? Like any virus, many wild and crazy theories have floated around as to the coronavirus's origins. Among the most credible is the suggestion that eating bats has led to the outbreak. Yes, that's right, actual bats. It's a popular food item in China. Many of them are sold in food markets. Before the spreading had begun, many Chinese internet stars had been taking videos of themselves eating bat soup. This caused a public outcry, as many feared it could lead to viewers attempting to eat bats themselves. Several of the online figures soon issued apologies. The lesson here, people, is that if one of your friends offers you a bat, just say no. The coronavirus is believed to have been transformed from bats to humans. Another theory lies with snakes. But this isn't the first time we've encountered the coronavirus. While it seems like it's only entering the zeitgeist now, doctors and scientists have been identifying it since the 60s, when it first appeared in a form of bronchitis virus in chickens. It was then discovered in human subjects, who seemed to have cold symptoms in their nasal cavities. They were named human coronavirus 229E and human coronavirus OC43. Oh, and as far as the name coronavirus, it stems from the Latin word corona, meaning crown or halo. Halo? In what universe are these deadly viruses heavenly? Actually, the name derives from the solar corona-like shape that a virus resembles when seen through an electron microscope. In December of 2019, the World Health Organization detected a case of pneumonia in the city of Wuhan, China. While little to no info has been released as to the details of this particular case, scientists confirmed it to be coronavirus. Several more cases were later reported. Investigations linked the cases to the Wuhan market, where a wide array of animals were being sold. On top of animal organs, many of the stands sold raw parts of chickens, snakes, deer, and bats. The outbreak was linked to the animals sold there, as patients who contracted the virus were also found to have visited the market. By December 31st, the total number of cases confirmed were 27. On January 3rd, that number of cases had officially increased by 17, with 44 people confirmed to be sick with common respiratory disease. These diseases included bird flu and influenza. Other Asian countries such as Singapore announced that they'll be screening people on flights arriving from Wuhan. 3 days later, on January 7th, the number of patients was now 59, with Hong Kong treating 15 of their own. These subjects had one thing in common. They had all recently visited Wuhan. By January 11th, the first death of this coronavirus outbreak was reported. A 61-year-old Chinese man passed away in a hospital. He was suffering from severe pneumonia. The total number of cases was also revised down to 41, but it was spreading and things were getting much scarier. Jumping to January 20th, several countries around the globe were now screening flights arriving from Wuhan. More cases have now been reported from China, Thailand, South Korea, and Japan. The number of confirmed cases had climbed to 201, with 3 deaths. The rapid rate of new cases had many countries worried about travelers arriving from Wuhan. The US confirmed its first case of coronavirus in Seattle, Washington on the 21st. In the days following, China announced that it would be closing off access to Wuhan as well as 2 other cities nearby. By the 26th of January, the number of reported cases had spiked to 2,000, with 81 deaths. The US reported its second case, while the first Canadian case was discovered after a person returning from Wuhan landed at the Toronto airport. Now that we have a proper timeline of the events up until the time of this recording, let's run through something I'm sure all of you wanted us to touch on. But before we continue, are you concerned about the overall state of your health? Perhaps you'd like our recent video on the 13 best exercises for beginners to get in shape in 2020. Or if you'd like something a little lighter, try our new clip on 7 ways to get rid of your double chin. Now, let's continue our discussion on coronavirus. How do we prevent the coronavirus? As I mentioned in the intro, there's currently no vaccine or cure for this disease. But you can bet that the world's top experts in medicine are working towards some sophisticated form of prevention. In the meantime, several forms of caution have to be taken. When we say that Wuhan and other Chinese cities have been locked down, we mean no traffic in or out. The city of Wuhan even banned general vehicle use. This means that 11 million people are without the use of an automobile. Things have not been pleasant for China as a whole. Officials decided to cancel 2 large temple fairs in the Lunar New Year. Another crucial move made by the Chinese health authorities is to stop the sale of animal foods in the marketplaces. You're likely asking yourself, all of that's good, but what can I do? Well, you can start by washing your hands at any given opportunity. This means with both soap and water. Wash them for at least 20 seconds. It's always smart to keep a bottle of hand sanitizer with you. Yep, you're about to be that annoying person who at any given moment is pulling out the hand sanitizer. Hey, it's better than contracting a disease. Not to mention cold, flu, and anything else out there. With illness, it sometimes all comes down to whether or not your hands are clean. If they aren't clean, make an effort not to touch your eyes, nose, and mouth. This way, you'll have less unwanted bacteria traveling into your system. If you know that you're sick, stay at home and recuperate. This way, there's less chance of spreading it. Speaking of your home, I understand spring cleaning is always a drag, especially when it comes early, but wiping down surfaces every now and then can be a huge help in preventing the spreading of germs. With that being said, only stay at home if you feel minor illness symptoms, ones that you are sure you can treat yourself. If you feel anything more severe, go to your nearest hospital. Healthcare professionals are urging the public to call ahead before visiting. This way, the staff's able to take proper precautions in preparing for your arrival. If a person with the coronavirus has been sitting in an area you're sitting at, just touching a surface that they put their hands on can make you vulnerable to the virus. If you know a person who's sick, get the heck away from them. All it takes is one interaction for a serious virus to spread from one person to another. You can also try wearing a face mask. If you live in a crowded city, chances are you've seen someone wearing a face mask before. While most people shy away from sporting one in public, you shouldn't be afraid to try one on yourself. This is particularly important for the flu season. If you're visiting a medical building, put one on just to be safe. Are you concerned about the coronavirus? Are you considering doing your own research on the subject after watching this video? Let us know in the comment section below. We'd love to hear from you. Enjoyed this video? Hit like, share, and subscribe to Bestie. Wait! What kind of Bestie would we be if we didn't tell you about our other awesome videos? Go ahead, choose the left or right video and enjoy.